لسوف أعود يا أمي أقبل رأسك الزاكي أبثك كل أشواقي وأرشف عطر يناك أمرغ في ثرى قدميك خدي حين ألقى.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، ملء السماوات وملء الأرض وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء من شيء ربنا بعد. ونستعينه استعانة راض بفضله، واثق بدفعه، مؤمل لنفعه، ونستغفره ونسترشده ونستهديه، ونؤمن به ونتوب إليه ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله. بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة، فكشف الله به الغمة، وفتح به أعينا عميا وآذانا صما وقلوبا غلفا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وعلى من اهتدى بهديه واتبع سنته إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الكلام كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، تحدثنا في الأسابيع الماضية عن المرأة في الجاهلية وقبل الإسلام، ثم عن مكانتها في الإسلام وكيف كرمها الإسلام. واليوم إن شاء الله سنذكر بعض الأمثلة للنساء في الإسلام. Last few weeks we were talking about the woman, how she has been treated in the other religions or other nations and before Islam, and how is she treated in Islam, and the Islam gives the woman the dignity and the honor. And today inshallah we're going to go through few examples of few women. It's so many examples that you cannot have it in maybe hundreds khutbas, but let us go through few examples of some of the women in Islam. So when we talk about how the Islam honors the woman, we have to give examples, otherwise we'll just be theoretical. But we see the first one who believe, enter Islam and believe in Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, actually it is a woman. She is a woman, not a man. So the first mu'min, believer in this religion of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, she is Aisha, Khadija bint Khuwailid رضي الله عنها. أم المؤمنين خديجة. She is the first one to believe. And actually she has a very important role that she played. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم received the wahi for the first time. He was in the Ghar Hira, in the cave. And the wahi came to him, the first contact between him and Jibril alayhi salam. He got very scared, terrified. He ran away and he went to his home, to Khadija radiallahu anha. And you see that he said, Zammiluni, Zammiluni, means cover me. He was shaking, terrified. He doesn't know what's going on. he didn't know what was going on. And the angel came and shake him. Iqra, read. Read. Ma'ana bikhara. He said, I don't read. Read. And the second time, third time. So this is, he came to Khadija radiallahu anha. And she was very calm. She is just made him tell what happened. And then her answer was a beautiful answer that made Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to relax. She said, Wallahi, Wallahi, kalla, nay, kalla, Wallahi la yukhzik Allah. She swear by Allah that Allah will never let you down. And she described Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with some of his qualities. Kalla, Wallahi la yukhzik Allah. فَإِنَّكَ تَصُلِ الرَّحِمِ. You always connect with the next of kin. وَتُخْرِ الضَّيْفَ. You give host to the guests. وَتُكْسِبُ الْمَعْدُومِ. The one who has nothing, you give him. وَتَحْمِلُ الْكَلِ. You carry the load on the people, from the people. وَتُعِينُ عَلَىٰ نَوَائِبِ الظَّهْرِ. عَلَىٰ نَوَائِبِ الْحَقِّ. And you help others in any calamity. This is the quality of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So now who is telling him this? A woman. Now to also he become calm. And then she took him and visited her cousin, Waraqa ibn Nawfal. And Waraqa ibn Nawfal, in Jahiliyyah, he adopted Christianity and he have knowledge from the Bible and from the Torah. And she went with him and explained. Then he said, Wallahi innaka la nabi hazi al-umma. By Allah, you are the prophet of this nation. And what you have received is the wahd, the same revelation, the same that came to Prophet Musa alayhi salam and all the prophets before him. So this is the position of Khadija radiallahu anha. She believed, the first believer, and not only that, she played a very important role to support this religion. So when you talk about the woman, we see the woman is not just minor or not doing anything, but actually she did a very important role. She supported Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi salam all the time. With his money, with her help or her advice, she had lots of wisdom. She was much older than him. When he married her, he was 25 and she was 40. And she was a rich woman. She employed him to go and do the trade with her money, and he doubled her profits. And after that, she realized the quality of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and she actually is the one proposed through her relatives for him for marriage. So she played a very important role, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had lots of support from her and also from his uncle. But when she died, then he felt the difference. So Khadija radiallahu anha, all the Jibreel alayhi salam, he came one time to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he said, Khadija is coming to you. So he said, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ أَقْرِئَهَا السَّلَامِ مِنَ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending salam to her. We're not going to today going through the manaqib. If we talk about Khadija radiallahu anha, we talk a lot. But we just say a small one. That وَبَشِّرْهَا بِبَيْتٍ فِي الْجَنَّةِ مِنْ قَصَبٍ لَا صَخَبَ فِيهِ وَلَا نَصَبٍ. That this is Jibreel alayhi salam, he telling Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending salam to Khadija radiallahu anha and give her the glad tidings. So not only 10 people who are actually washing bil Jannah, there's so more than 10 people, many. So this hadith very clear that give her glad tidings that she will have a house in paradise. لا صخب فيه ولا نصب, means that there is no quiet and there's no you should not feel tired. She will be relaxing in this house from in the Jannah. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always after she passed away many years, even when Aisha radiallahu anha used to get jealous from Khadija, Even Khadija passed away a long time ago, but Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always remember her with the good things. And he said, she's the one believed in me and Rasala when everybody denied. And she's the one give me support when everybody did not give me support. So this is the role of the of one of the women. The first believer in Islam is a woman. And let us also go to the second example. The first shaheed in Islam, martyr, it's not a man, it's also a woman. Ala Yasir, Sumayya, and her husband Yasir, and her son Ammar, used to be slaves. And the people of the Kuffar of Quraysh used to torture them. And at the beginning of Islam, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he didn't have any support. So he was just passing by through those people and telling them, Sabran ala Yasir, inna mawidakum al-jannah. He cannot do anything for them except to tell them, have patience. We will meet in paradise. But for so much torture that they used, the Kuffar used to take them, put them in the hot sun of Mecca, and they cover them with iron, and cover them with the sand, the almost boiling. And due to this pressure, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Kuffar telling them to just say, I disbelieve, so we'll let you, we'll remove the torture from you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in the Quran that you are allowed to do this under so much pressure, you say, as long as your heart still mutma'inni bil iman, illa man ukriha wa qalbuhu mutma'innu bil iman. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave permission under so much torture that he can say the word of kufr. But as long as his heart completely satisfied with the believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive. So both men, they said the word. But the woman refused. You see here now, you see the difference. I'm not saying all the time the man is better. Now the woman here was better than the man. Because her husband and her son, under so much torture, they said the word of kufr, and of course went to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this ayat was revealed that as long as qalbu mutma'in, feel secure with belief, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives. But the woman refused. Ista'samat bis-sabr. She has lots of patience and endurance more than the two men, her son and her father and her husband. And she refused. So Abu Jahl got very angry. She was owned, she was a slave with Abu Jahl. Abu Jahl got very angry. He took his spear and he killed her. She became the first shaheed in Islam. So we're not talking about theoretically here that we treat the woman good or the woman has a very high status in Islam. This is the reality. The first shaheed, the first believer in Islam is a woman. The first shaheed in Islam is a woman. And if you can go through last week I mentioned Aisha radiallahu anha about the knowledge. There are many scholars, I actually adduct through the many scholars in Islam are women. Many scholars in Islam. Al-Hafiz ibn Asakir, one of the biggest scholars in Hadith, Al-Hafiz ibn Asakir. He has his own teachers, he has some 80 something, 84, 85, 86 women, scholars. One of his teachers, close to 85 or 84 or 83 something, 80 something women. And he is very famous. Aisha radiallahu anha, she was described by Ata and other people that she, if you take the knowledge of all the women of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and compare with Aisha radiallahu anha, her knowledge is over, above. She had lots of knowledge in fiqh, lots of knowledge in fara'id, which is, you know, how this is distributing the inheritance. and the hadith, she has musnad. I checked the how many hadith that she narrated. It's 2,210. The highest one is Abu Huraira, 5,700. Abu Huraira. And then the second level is 2,000. So Abu Huraira is 5,000 because he was very close to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, staying in the mosque. Somebody asked why Abu Huraira has all these ahadith. Because he's from Ahl al-Suffa. People of Suffa, they had no money, they had no place. They were staying in the mosque. So he was always with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for 3 years. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam made dua for him. But Allah, may Allah give him the ability to memorize a hadith. But 5,000 next level, which 2,600, 2,200, 2,200, actually Ibn Umar, and then Anas ibn Malik and Aisha. They are in the same level, 2,200 both. And then 2,600. She's like the second level from Rawat al-Hadith. She had lots of knowledge in fiqh, and she's not the only one. This, when you go through the history, you find the daughter of Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib. She got all his knowledge. Actually, when she got married to a man, and one of his students, then he said, I'm going to go. Well, sir, where are you going? He said, I'm going to Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib Majlis to learn. He just, maybe he was learning for 1 year or so. She said, come, stay at home. I'm going to teach you all the knowledge of Sa'id ibn Musayyib. Bint al-Imam Malik, the daughter of Imam Malik, and his Jariya, the slave woman, both of them are considered from the scholars. And so on and so on. Al-Mithamiyah, his daughter. And some of those women used to give fatwa, and they sign fatwa sometimes by the father and the daughter. So if you go through, this will take a long time, but you go through this, you find that so many scholars in Islam are women. So women are not just told, just keep away from, just stay home and do nothing. No. And if you go for ibadat and for sadaqah, you'll be amazed. Like, description, let us get description of Hafsa, which is a wife of Rasulullah SAW, daughter of Umar ibn Khattab. One time Rasulullah SAW entrusted her in some secret, as you know, in Surah Al-Tahrim, and she said what he told her not to say, and he divorced her. He divorced Hafsa. Then came Jibreel alayhi salam to Rasulullah SAW. And this is a shahada. This is now the statement from Jibreel, but actually it is not from Jibreel himself. It's coming from Allah, because he said something about Jannah. Jibreel doesn't know unless Allah tell him. So he told Rasulullah SAW, a very small statement. Raji'aha means that return her back. فَإِنَّهَا صَوَّامَ قَوَّامَ وَزَوْجُكَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. صَوَّامَ means not Saima. When you hear some sister, her name is Saima, means that she's fasting. But Sawama means Shigat Mubalagha, means that continuing fasting. Sawama. Like exaggerating means Sawama. She's most of the time fasting. Qawama also the same thing. She always making qiyam. This is a statement from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because he said, وَنَهَا زَوْجُكَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. She is your wife in paradise. So this is the description of how those people who hold these women used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is not for her for only. This is a description for Zainab bint Jahsh, Umm al-Mu'mineen. She used to give a sadaqah. Actually, she was called Mafza al-Yatama wal-Aramil, the refuge for orphans and widows. Zainab bint Jahsh, another wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She's the refuge to the yatama and orphans. The orphans and the widows, they always have refuge with her. Go to her for help. She used to distribute everything she has. Actually, she used to work at home doing some clothes or something, and then sell it and give sadaqah, whatever she makes. Because Rasulullah SAW described her, he said, He said in one hadith, أَسْرَعَكُنَّ لِحَاقًا بِي أَطْوَلُكُنَّ يَدًا. He told his wife, the one who's going to be join me after I die, the first one, the fastest one, is the one who was the longest hand. So the wife of Rasulullah sallam saw, just she compares her hands. So they put their hands together, each other, and then see which one is longer hand than the other. But actually Rasulullah sallam was, he meant that's the one long hand means that she gave more sadaqah. And they discovered that after that she is the first one, she passed away. And Aisha radiallahu anha also, she used to give lots of sadaqah. There was a description that one time she received Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, she received from him 100,000 dirham. She distributed all, completely. And then the woman who helping her, she said, you are fasting. Why don't you save one dirham? Out of 100,000, we can buy some meat. She said, if you remind me, I could have done it. This is how, those are the women, the example for us, for sadaqah, for ibadah, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Almost like she was fasting the whole year, except some days. She was almost fasting. Aisha radiallahu anha, when she married Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she was about 9 or 10 years old. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away, she was 18. And this is the time she learned a lot. And usually the person in this age, this is the time to learn. You pick up everything you notice. That's why you study from when you go to school from 6 until 18 and 20, that's it. This is the year. She learned all this fiqh from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then she passed away, she was 66. So up from 18 to 66, that close to 40 something years, she was teaching. What she learned, if she just learned without teaching, without giving the fiqh and giving the ahadith, then nobody will benefit. So this is Aisha radiallahu anha. Now when you talk about jihad, we know that the woman, she doesn't fight. But this is not the case all the time. Sometimes she has to fight. And you see some example of women that they fought. The Battle of Uhud is a clear example of that. Nusayba bint Ka'ab. Maybe you heard this name the first time. Nusayba bint Ka'ab, Umm Amara. She said she went to the Battle of Uhud site helping the army of the Muslim for water and help the person who injured. Then in Hazam al-Muslimun, the Muslims, the first were winning and then they start defeated, getting defeat, and many people left. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was only protected by close to 10 or plus or minus, 10 people only. Abu Bakr Siddiq, Umar al-Khattab, Ali ibn Abi Talib, only about 10 people. The defending Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the battle. Now this woman changed. Now she's not gonna help the injured. Now she has to fight. So she went to fight, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw her with her two sons and her husband. She doesn't have a dirah, like a ters, like a shield. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw some people leaving the battlefield. She said, give your shield to the one who's going to fight. So she took the shield from him and she started fighting. And she defended Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the degree that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, like, لمقام نسيبة بنت كعب اليوم خير من مقام فلان وفلان. We didn't mention the names. He didn't mention the names. Or maybe the Rawi did not mention the name because he doesn't want to talk ill or something about those people who left the battlefield. But this is a woman. She said the only problem that the people with the horses causing all the problems. Because Muslims didn't have any horses. She was on her feet. People coming with the horses. And she said, فَتَرَّسْتُ. She stood fast until she avoids the man coming with the horse, and then she hit the horse from the back. Then he fell down. Then she came with her son and killed this man. And Rasulullah, he was very happy. See this woman, he said, whenever I look, I found Nusaybah. He looked to his right, he found Nusaybah fighting. This is a woman. I looked to the left, the same thing. So, and this is not the only example, there's so many examples. Example of sabr and da'wah in the few minutes. There's another sahabiyah. His name is Bint Mulhan. She's the mother of Anas ibn Malik. And this woman, Anas ibn Malik, his father, was a kafir, and this woman started telling Anas ibn Malik about Islam. And her husband, his name is Malik ibn Nadr, he got angry. He said, don't you know, teach him these things. She said, no, I'm preparing him something good. She kept telling her son, Anas ibn Malik, about Shahada, about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Eventually, she took her son to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, take my boy to be your servant. He worked for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for 10 years, Anas ibn Malik. And that's why he narrated close to 2,000 hadiths, 2,200, just a little bit more than Aisha radhiyallahu anha. And this woman, when her husband left her, he died. Then now she met Abu Talha. Abu Talha is a very good man, but he was a kafir. So he wanted to marry her, and she refused. She said, my mahr is to go and to become a Muslim. And he eventually became a Muslim, and she married him. Now the story, that very long story, but we know that she got a son from him, and then he was outside, and the son died. He was sick, and the son died. Now we see how the woman behaved. She said, if one of our wives want to come, and she, you hear screaming, your son died, you know, you will get, you know, collapse and all this. No, what she did, she told nobody mention anything to the father. And Abu Talha arrived at home. She prepared good food, good dinner, and she wore the best of her clothes, and perfume and everything. Then he ate, he was very happy, and he spent the night with the wife. And in the morning, she told him, what do you say about people borrowed something, and then after they enjoyed with it, the one who gives them this, he won't take it back, and they refuse. He said, ma ansafu, they shouldn't do this. She prepared. Now he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you this son as a ariyah, as a, you know, it's only to borrow. Now he took it back. Then he realized, now how this gave him the news, you know. Eventually he went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, Barakallahu lakuma fi laylatikuma. Mean Allah, bless your night that you spend with your wife. And the result of this night, she got a son that he was a very good Muslim, and he had 10 children. They all memorizing Quran, and they all fought for Sabilillah. And this is another example of the woman in Islam. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر لكم استغفروا إنه الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على خير المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. عباد الله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد. اللهم صل على محمد في الأولين. اللهم صل على محمد في الآخرين. اللهم صل على محمد في كل وقت وحين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين وأعلي بفضل الكلمة الحق والدين واخذ الكفرة أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم لا تجعل لنا في هذا اليوم ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا مبتلا إلا عافيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا أسيرا إلا فككت أسره ولا حاجة هي لك رضا إلا قضيتها وسرتها يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ارحم ضعفنا واجبر كسرنا وتولى أمرنا. اللهم أحسن خلاصنا واهد قلوبنا واشرح صدورنا وآمن روعاتنا واختم بالباقيات الصالحات. أعمالنا. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وآخر الصلاة.